Have you got one? I've got the other one. Can we
have it? Oh my God, he has.
That your fans are like reflect who you are. I'm so happy. Can I keep this?
Thank you. Oh, funny. Okay.
I couldn't have sang that to sing Whitney, so let's do that now. The day that she passed away, I was supposed to meet her. No, and I was in a rehearsal for a Diana Ross tribute at the Clive Davis party. And I was with Brandy and Monica, and I was just so overwhelmed. It was 2012. And I felt like I won a competition. I was just looking around, like, these are all the people that I grew up listening to, and I'm standing on the stage, and I was so not present. I was just kind of whirling around, and I remember her daughter came in and she said, "My mom has been watching your YouTube videos and she'd love to meet you." And I just melted, because if anyone knows me, Whitney's the reason I wanted to sing, because she sang loud.
The queen!
And my manager was trying to organize a time for us to meet, and it was late that day that she passed away. I was so grateful to know that she heard me sing. And there is no one like Whitney Houston. Just the charisma, the control, the technique, the power, the ease. Just how organic it was. It was just her and a microphone. And that will always be my biggest inspiration, is being good when you're exposed. So I just want to say thank you, Whitney, for giving really loud children, aka me, the inspiration to stay loud. No, it's this higher. Just give me a second. Zoom in. Feel free to keep filming. No, I've got, I can't. I've got a different tone. It will just throw me off even more. It's fine. I don't know the passion inside. Can't run from myself. I know where to hide. Technical fault.